pray for them because they need it. They're our pastors, they're our shepherds, our leaders, and we're going to pray for them. Somebody's going to stand in, and all that will come, they'll come up and pray for them. Anyways, with that going on, just a couple little short announcements here. The Christmas drama, we do have a package today at 3 o'clock, right? Everyone that wants to be here or be a part of that, please come. Dandy and Terry, they're going to get it together. It's going to be awesome. December 22nd is when evening service at 6 p.m. I'm sure we'll get a flyer posted soon to share because the message of Jesus Christ is going to be displayed on that night. So if you're not in the play, I urge you to pray for them. Pray for those involved. Pray for Tandy and Terry as they lead this thing where God's Spirit can have freedom to move people to come to Him.
Right.
Amen?
Amen?
Because that's what we're here to do. And let's see what else we have. Sister Stephanie will be preaching tonight, 6 p.m. Pray for her this evening before the service. We have prayer meeting tomorrow night at 5:30 p.m. We just ask you to come as well. And then Thursday, the 17th, ladies' meeting, right? It's going to be here. It's going to be here at the church. So, ladies, come out the 17th, 6:30. That's this Thursday. Come out. Come together, sisters in Christ. Amen. And then we also still taking up donations for hurricane relief. I know the men's ministry of the CH Church in general has been going between North Carolina and Florida, sending supplies. We are getting a bunch of donations here for the local area in Elgin. A couple of the other churches in the area, we're getting stuff together. Please bring it ASAP. We are storing them all in the old church, the old sanctuary in the back on the right side. Water, non-perishable items, diapers, I'm sure anything like that would be a great use to those in North Carolina right now. So, and also remember to pray for them because they need it the most. Amen. Warren also wanted me to let you all know he did get in touch with the evangelist. He's excited about coming. Our revival is the first week in November. I can't remember the dates. The first through third? The third? Starts November 3rd. If you come the 3rd, you're going to know when the rest of the days are. 3rd through the 8th. So, evangelist is excited. He's ready to come to give the word out to us. What's his name?
Chris Jeter.
Brother Chris Jeter. So, if you're not able to come some of the nights, unfortunately, like me, I got to work, unfortunately. Pray for the service. Pray for the people that come. Because we're going to have more than just our members here. There's going to be people from all over. Pray for the evangelist, and he'll get a word from the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
All right. So does anybody have a prayer request this morning? Any open prayer requests? My Aunt Teresa, she's been in the, is she still in the hospital, Mom?
She's still in the hospital.
She's in the hospital fighting some things. Remember her. Anyone else? Any other?
Just got a message online from Sister Faye Combs asking if we would remember her in prayer.
Yes. Sister Combs, Brother Combs, and Melissa as well.
She says she's in a lot of pain.
In his hands, he's got the whole world. In his
If you can soak that in deep into your soul, you know where your answer comes from. Amen? So everyone, please stand. Those that are going to come up, Sister Tina, you can stand for Sister Report. Brother Justin, please come on and follow. Those who will come, please come. We're going to lay hands. We're going to pray for our pastor and our former pastor as well. They both need physical touches, and our First Lady pastor as well. Anyways, y'all that will come, please come. We'll lay hands and we'll pray for the other needs. Thank you. Church, when we worship here on now, I ask you to focus on God Himself. That is the God that we serve. He is over all things. It's what we're here for, to lift His name up. Amen. Ushers, let's come on up. We're going to take up an offering this morning. And I tell you what, Brother Bruce, you want to pray for the offering, brother?
Heavenly Father, Lord, we ask you to bless this offering, Lord.
Bless those
who give and bless those who cannot give. Lord, we ask you to please touch this service and be the name of the speaker. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.
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 We have got to get where we need to be.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
God's touched her and healed her, and it's just so good to have everybody back with us this morning. Amen. I would like to give my pastor honor this morning. Amen. I don't take this position lightly, and that he opened up this pulpit to allow me to stand here this morning. And I give God all the glory and all the honor, but I do thank my pastor this morning. My prayers are with him and Sister Paula this morning. And I believe that God is going to touch them, and he's going to heal them supernaturally. And we're going to send Pastor back here. Amen. Glory to God. In Jesus' name. Glory to God. Hallelujah. God is good. The title of my message is A Fresh Wind of the Holy Ghost. Now more than ever, we need a fresh wind from Sean to blow in this house like never before across this land with everything that's happening. I know that my God is real, and he is still the same yesterday, today, and forever. And just like he did it before, he's still blowing across this land. Amen. Glory to God. That same wind, the fire, the Holy Ghost that blew in on the day of Pentecost is still blowing today. That same baptism is still available to those who will open their hearts and receive him today. We need a fresh wind. Amen. Glory to God. There's a song that I like to sing, and Brother Jimmy, I thought of, you might know it, the Holy Ghost Revival. The lyrics go like this. It says, we need an old-fashioned heaven sent Holy Ghost Revival touching me and touching you. We need a sin-erasing restoration Holy Ghost Revival. Send it, Lord. Send it anew. Amen. How many of you are expecting revival? We got revival coming up in November. I am looking forward for revival. This young man named Crystal got to hear him, and he is on fire. Amen. He is full of the Holy Ghost. His wife is also very anointed, has a very powerful voice in singing, and I know that they are going to be a blessing, and I am looking forward to revival. Amen. If you can, if you'll stand to your feet with me, we'll get right on into the scriptures this morning. Our scripture text comes from Luke 24:49 and Acts 2:1-4. And behold, I send the promise of my Father upon you, that tarry ye in the city of Jerusalem until you be endued with power from on high. And then Acts 2:1-4 says, and when the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all with one accord in one place. And suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled all of the house where they were sitting. And there appeared unto them cloven tongues like as a fire, and it sat upon each of them.
Yes.
And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost. They were all filled, not just some, but they were all filled with the Holy Ghost. And they began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. Brother Shaw, can you pray?
Lord, we just thank you for you and you alone and your Spirit that you gave to us, Lord, your comfort, God, and the power that comes from on high. Lord, we just thank you for that. God, we thank you for our sister, Lord, that she gives the word, God, your servant. Lord, we just ask that you be with her, Lord. Let your words, let your Spirit, God, manifest through her, Lord. And let the words pierce our hearts, God, like a sword, Lord. Let us be able to understand what you want us to hear today, Father. God, so we can be better equipped, better prepared to be a better servant for you and you alone, our Heavenly Father. We ask this in your name. Amen.
Everybody can be seated.
Yes,
glory to God. Luke 24:49, Jesus tells his disciples, he says, to tarry, to wait, to expect until you be endued with power from on high. That is one of the hardest things, I think, Sister Heidi, that we have here in America today. We don't want to wait on God. We want it right now.
That's right.
But God told the disciples before he would go, before he would ascend up into heaven, he would say, go and tarry ye in Jerusalem until you be endued with the power from on high. Today we need the power of the Holy Ghost like never before, because we are living in some dark days. We are living in some times like we have never seen across this land. There is so much evil in this land that is rising up, and the enemy wants us to make us think that they've got full control, but I'm here to let them as I said, that was spoken by Jesus before he would go up. The disciples, they had been with Jesus for 3 years. They had watched him. They watched all of the miracles and everything that had taken place. They watched him raise up people from the dead, Sean. And they had been with him, but that wasn't enough. Just to be with Jesus, Jesus said, go and to tarry and to wait. They needed this dunamis power to be able to stand. You and I need that dunamis power, that same Holy Ghost power that they were to wait on. You and I need it today like never before. Amen. Hallelujah. But we don't need it just one time, Brother Sean. We need a refilling every single day. When we get up in the morning, we need to be seeking the Holy Ghost for a fresh touch. Hallelujah. Because I'm telling you, you cannot stand in these last days if you don't have it. Hallelujah. Glory to God. The Holy Spirit is the one who keeps us connected to the way, Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, and our Father in heaven. Without Him, we are just simply powerless. We are simply powerless. Amen. We can try, Brother Bruce, to do it in our own strength, but we will surely fall. Because Jesus Himself, He said, you're going to need Him. You're going to need, I have to go away so that I can send Him. I'm not going to leave you here out on your own. I'm not going to leave you all by yourself, Crystal. I'm going to send one that you're going to need, and He's going to be your comforter. He's going to help you. He's going to guide you in these last days. He's going to give you the power that you need to overcome this flesh and sin and be able to be a witness and a light in this world like never before. Amen. If the disciples need Him, we need Him. Jesus, our Lord and Savior, He said we need Him today. To be endued with power, this was the power which would be given them, the disciples, by the descent of the Holy Spirit. We know the story well on the day of Pentecost that we read about in Acts 2. The power of speaking in tongues, the working of miracles, and the preaching of the gospel with the help of the Holy Spirit. This was not just for them. Some people think that this time of being endued with power was only for them back then in that day, in the Bible day, and that these things ceased. But I'm here to tell you, miracles, can anybody attest to me and tell me that miracles have stopped happening today? Amen. I don't think that He's just going to take part of it and do just part of it. Joel 2:28 says, and it shall come to pass afterwards that I'm going to pour out my Spirit upon all flesh. That I'm going to pour out my Spirit upon all. Somebody say that word, all flesh. All flesh, not just somebody, not just a few chosen. And He said, I'm going to pour it out on everyone that will open up their hearts. It is for every one of you. It's not for a select few individuals, but it is for everyone. But you have to do something. I can't give it to you. Your mama and your daddy can't give it to you. Brother Sean over here cannot give it to you. You have to open up your heart and just be willing. The only thing that you have to do, you must be born again. You cannot receive the baptism of the Holy Ghost until you are born again. That is a gift. The Holy Spirit, when we are born again, comes to live in each of the believers. But this right here is a gift from the Holy Ghost. Amen. And it goes on to say, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Your old men shall dream dreams, and your young men shall see visions. Your daughters shall prophesy. We need to see the daughters of God. We need to see our daughters prophesying. It says, our old men shall dream dreams, and our young men, John, will see visions. Amen. Glory to God. We need to see the Holy Spirit moving in our church, in our body. God is still very evident for those who will receive this morning, for those who will open up to Him. He is not a dead God. He is still alive. He is breathing. And He is coming the church. I preached here a lot lately about the rapture of the church, Brother Sean, and about the return of our Lord Jesus Christ. I'm looking forward to him coming back. But until he comes back, there is still a work to be done. Hallelujah. He is still pouring out his spirit just like he did way back then. Amen. Glory to God. He's worthy. Acts 2:16 through 18 says, after the disciples, they were baptized with the Holy Spirit. Peter would give his first sermon, says, denying Jesus for three times. We all know about Peter. Peter was with Jesus. He was one of the disciples. He was with him every day when he walked here on this earth. But it is not the same as having the Holy Ghost inside of you. He is the one that we need to fill us up, to give us that power to be able to speak.
Amen.
Jesus said, I have to go away so that I can send my spirit. It's Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. I am not talking one day, and I'm not saying Jesus is any less. He is the Son of the living God. Amen. He is the King of kings, and he is the Lord of lords. But the Father is God, the Son is God, and the Holy Spirit is God. Amen. You will never see one working without the other. They are not gods this morning. A lot of people I've seen out there on the Facebook and the YouTube, they're confused. They don't understand that my God is one God in three persons. Amen. He is not, if you don't put an S on there, he's not gods. He is not, you don't have the Holy Spirit as a God. You don't have the Father as a God. You don't have Jesus as a God. They're not separate gods. They are one God working together. And when you read throughout Scripture, when you study full time, when you study the Scriptures, you'll know that this is the truth. It will bear witness with you today. Amen.
Amen.
Glory to God. Peter, he speaks on this day. He gets up after being endued with that Holy Ghost power. And for the, you've got all of the Jews, all of those that were surrounding, all of those who had crucified the Savior, he stood up and he gave his first sermon to proclaim the gospel, the good news. He was no longer ashamed. He was no longer fearful. Amen. We went to this women's conference this weekend, and the same thing that I talked about on Wednesday, that God didn't give us a spirit of fear. That's a spirit that attacks God's people. Amen. He didn't give it to us. If you've got a spirit of fear this morning, that comes from the enemy. But the Lord said he gave us a love, power, and a sound mind this morning.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. And this day, that's what we receive when the Holy Ghost comes inside. We saw a fearful Peter before. He wouldn't even, you know, tell them that he was the one that was with Jesus. But now we have him up on the day of Pentecost, and he's giving his first sermon, and he's declaring the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. When Peter was done, those who heard him, they were pricked in their hearts. This was the convicting power of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Glory to God. And they said unto Peter, what shall we do? Amen. They were looking to Peter, what shall we do? On the day of Pentecost, over 3,000 people, believers, gave their heart, their lives, because Peter stood up, because the Holy Spirit had come to live inside of him. Amen. Glory to God. 3,000 souls gave their hearts to the Lord, and the church has kept on growing to this day. To this day, how many believers do we have? I believe there is still a remnant of people, Brother Sean. There's still a people that's looking, and they're ready, and they're getting ready to go home. Amen. There's still a people out there that is calling on the name of Jesus. They haven't sold out to this world. This world has nothing for you. Amen. What is the profit of man if he gains this whole world and yet he loses his soul? What is it going to profit you, young man? What is it going to profit you, young girl, young lady? What's it going to profit you to gain this world? This world has nothing for us, Crystal. It has absolutely nothing for us, Cindy. It's passing away. It's passing away, except the Word of God. all of the pleasures, all of the desires of this world. Do not put your hope in this world because it's going away. Amen. Glory to God. I know that for 1,000 years we will reign with Christ here on this earth. Amen. After we are raptured and we go and they have the tribulation, and at the end, at the very end of the tribulation, we will come back with our Lord and Savior. Amen. And we will rule and reign for 1,000 years. And then at the end of that 1,000 years, you're going to find the judgment seat. If your name was not written, if your name is not written in the Lamb's Book of Life here this morning, you need to find yourself an altar. If you are here and you have any doubt in your mind, don't waste time getting down to these altars. Amen. Glory to God. He said, whosoever will this morning. Glory to God. He's coming back, but there is going to be a time of judgment where every soul will have to stand before God. And only those who have been taken in the rapture, those who were martyred during that time, to me, if you don't want to accept the Lord Jesus Christ right now, you're not going to. It's going to be very hard for you to turn your heart to Him during that tribulation period. Wow. It is a period that is coming on this land. It's the wrath of God. It's going to be poured out. And you think what we have seen is bad now, it's nothing compared to what is coming. There's going to be a false peace that's going to come on this earth. You're going to get a false sense of security when the Antichrist rises up and he's going to sign a 7-year peace treaty. There will be that sense of peace. I know I preached about this, but I feel it in my spirit. Somebody needs to hear this, because you're not quite there. You're still sitting on that fence that Pastor talks about. You haven't completely sold out to the Lord, and you haven't completely sold out to the world. You still got your foot here. Amen. You're one foot here and one foot there. But like our pastor has preached and he's told and he's tried to get it across, the devil owns the fence. Amen. You are either hot or cold. You are either completely sold out or you are not. The Lord Jesus Christ is getting ready to come out. Amen. John 3:16, you know it well. It says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever should believe in him would not perish, but have everlasting life. We know that after the judgment seat and all of the evil has been judged and they're thrown into the lake of fire, nobody wants to go to the lake of fire. Hell is temporary. If you go to hell, you're going to end up in that lake of fire, though. That's only the beginning of what will be for all eternity. You will feel torment and pain. I can't scare you into hell, but I can sure warn you and tell you about it. I can't keep you from burning in that lake for all eternity, but I can sure try with everything inside of this preacher's heart today. Lord, save them. Lord, deliver them. Set them free today. That is my heart's cry. I know that's our heart's cry, Brother Sean. Hallelujah. You don't want to go there. You don't want to end up in eternity separated from God, because outside of his presence, even Jesus said, Lord, why have you forsaken me? You see, Jesus going up to that cross that day, I know this is not part of my message, but I really feel strongly to minister to this. The Lord going up to the cross, he had been beaten. He had been whipped. Amen. He was unrecognizable. He had blood coming down his face and down his back. And he was put on this cross. But let me tell you, Jesus knew. And he could have at any minute called all of the angels, called them down to rescue him from going up that hill, from going on that cross. But he chose willingly to go.
Right.
He had a free will. He did not have to die for us. But yet he chose to. Everything he did it for you. He did it for me.
Yes.
He didn't have to. He paid a debt he did not owe. And I owe a debt that I could never pay. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Somebody needs to hear that today.
Amen.
He knew not because of the pain that he was going to suffer, not because he was beaten, not because he would take the nails in his hands and in his feet, not because he would wear a bloody crown, not because they would pluck his beard, did he stay on that cross that day. He knew he would be separated. He knew, he agonized about it in the garden before he would go up to the cross. And he said, not my will, but thy will be done. He didn't fear the pain of the suffering, what he did not want, and that he knew he was going to have to go through in order for it to be done. In order for it to be done, he had to experience being separated from the Father. We don't want to be separated ever. He did that for us, Sean. He took all of it upon his shoulder. Every bit of wrath that is coming upon this world today. If you are not a believer today, it is going to be poured out in these last days like never before. But if you are, I urge you, if you're not, to get saved. But that's what he did. He spared us from what's coming. We won't have to pay for it. We will be spared from wrath. We go through tribulation. He told us, he said, you're going to go through tribulation in this world. You're going to go through hard times. You're going to go through times of persecution and suffering in this world. But my wrath, you will not have to suffer. Because it's already been paid for on the cross of Calvary.
That's right.
Amen. Give him a hand clap of praise for that. Hallelujah. 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 Going forward, the Holy Spirit not only fell upon others, but also granted the disciples a fresh anointing after they prayed for boldness to proclaim God's word. In Acts 4:31, it says, and when they had prayed, the place was shaken where they were assembled together, and they were all filled. You hear that? That word again says all were filled with the Holy Ghost, and they spake the word of God with boldness. We need the power. I would not be standing up here today if I was not filled with the Holy Ghost. Amen. Because this is not a place to take lightly. Amen. Because I have to stand before God one day and give an account for what I spoke to y'all. Amen. I take this more serious than I would even a doctor's position. Amen. Who holds, you think they hold your life in their hands. Amen. But one little word that I could say up here could turn somebody away from God for all eternity. I don't take this lightly. And also, if I did not warn you and tell you that there was a devil out there, that hell is real. Some people don't believe that hell is real. But if I didn't tell you, I would be responsible for your lives.
That's right.
I don't take it lightly. Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. So we need boldness. The only way to really have true boldness to proclaim the gospel, the good news, amen, is by seeking the Holy Ghost. We know that there was a great outpouring on the Gentiles, that it was not just for the Jews. I preached this throughout all of my message, that it is for everybody. Cornelius' home, he was a Gentile and he was praying, and God would send Peter to minister to that household, and that whole household would be baptized just like they were on the day of Pentecost, with the evidence of speaking in other tongues. Acts 10:44-47 says, while Peter yet spake these words, the Holy Ghost fell on all of them which heard the word, and they of the circumcision which believed were astonished, as many as came with Peter, because that on the Gentiles also was poured out the gift of the Holy Ghost. For they heard them speak with tongues and magnify God. The scripture says that the Spirit fell on them just like from the beginning. Amen. Glory to God. The Holy Ghost is for everybody this morning. Who is the Holy Ghost? Who is that Holy Spirit this morning? I'm going to go over this real quick because I believe God wants to do a work around these altars this morning. He is the Ruach of God. This meaning of the Hebrew word Ruach is the breath, the wind of God. We saw him in the beginning over the waters in Genesis. Amen. He was in the beginning hovering. He is the one. He takes part. Remember I said you don't see one, you don't see two, but you see all three working together because John 1:1 says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Amen. In the beginning, you had the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen. He is God. The Bible declares that the Holy Spirit is God. Acts 5:3-4 says, but Peter said, Ananias, why has Satan filled thine heart to lie to the Holy Ghost and to keep back part of the price of the land? Whilst it remained, was it not thine own? And after it was sold, was it not in thine own power? Why hast thou conceived this thing in thine heart? Thou hast not lied unto men, but unto God. This right here reinforces the idea that the Holy Spirit is not just an influence, but he is fully divine. He is God this morning. He possesses the characteristics of God, the Father, and Jesus Christ. He's present everywhere. Psalms 139:7-8 says, where can I go from your spirit? Where can I flee from your presence? If I go into the heavens, you're there. And if I make my bed in the depths, you are there. Amen. Glory to God. The Holy Spirit, he is all-knowing. 1 Corinthians 2:10-11 says, but God hath revealed them unto us by his Spirit. For the Spirit searcheth all things, yea, the deep things of God. For what man knoweth the things of a man, save the spirit of man which is in him? Even so the things of God knoweth no man, but the Spirit of God. Amen. He is the third person. We talked about that. We see that he is the third person of the Trinity, the Godhead. Matthew 28:19 says, go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. The Father, the first person, he sent the Son, the second person. However, the Son said that when he left the world, that he would send a third person, who was God, the Holy Spirit. The Spirit is God, but he's neither the Son, the Father, nor the Son. He's the third individual of the Trinity. He is the third person. As God exists, all three persons are called equal. However, as God has revealed himself to us, and as he interacts with us, each person of the Trinity has taken on certain roles. The Spirit directs attention to the Son, giving glory to the Son. And the Son directs attention to the Father. Yeah. All glory. Yeah. All honor. Not man. There's nobody alive. There's no created being out there that deserves all the glory and all of the honor and all of the praise that we can give to him today for what he has done. Amen. Glory to God. He is worthy, church. Hallelujah. He's a divine person with a mind, emotions, and will. He thinks and he knows. He can be grieved. He intercedes for us. He makes decisions according to his will. He is everything that we need. He's our comforter, our counselor, who will never leave us. He's Jesus' representative. He is the one who guides us into all truth. He tells what he has heard about the future. He reveals to us what he receives from Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. For just a second, I want to talk to you as we come to a close. Why we need to be endued with power from on high and to receive a fresh wind, an anointing of the baptism of the Holy Spirit, first and foremost, so that we can overcome this sinful flesh. First and foremost, so that we can overcome this sinful flesh that we are born in. There's not one of you here that was born that was righteous, that was holy, that was pure, that was good. Apart from God, you are not good.
Amen.
You can be a good person all day long. But apart from the Lord Jesus Christ, who is our Savior, who is our King, who hung, bled, and died. Why did he hang on that cross that day? If we were good, all of our good is sin is death. Our wages for our sin is what we deserve, is what we get. And you say, well, Sister Panji, I haven't sinned. Because sometimes when you ask people, well, have I sinned? I don't believe I've sinned. I don't believe I've ever done anything wrong. You do have some people out there. But if you start measuring yourself up to the Ten Commandments,
that's right. Come on.
And you think about what you have done with your life, I can guarantee you most of us have dishonored our mother and our father.
Amen.
That's right.
I can guarantee you that most of us have told a lie at some point in our life. We've stole something. There's some that may have taken the Lord's name in vain. We're all guilty of having idols before a holy God. It's called a cell phone. It's called Facebook. It's called a TV.
Amen.
We've got idols. That's the number one, says you should have no other gods. Anything that comes before you and God. So just with those few things that I have mentioned should convict you. If you were standing before a holy God on Judgment Day, if this was your day to go, if you died today and you stood before a holy God and you were judged according to the law, which you will be if you do not have the Lamb's blood of Jesus Christ applied to your life, you will be condemned for all eternity. Amen. That's why we need Jesus. It says the gift of God is eternal life through Christ Jesus. Amen. The Holy Spirit is the one who convicts. He reproves the world of sin. John 16:18 says, and when he is come, he will reprove the world of sin and of righteousness and of judgment. When Jesus gave the Great Commission, he knew that the disciples could not fulfill it in their own power. It was his plan to give them the same power that he had, that same resurrection power shown that raised him up out of that grave that day. It lives inside of you and I. We have resurrection power. That same resurrection power is available for each and every one of you today. Stand to your feet. Amen. Glory to God. Like I said, how do we receive the baptism and the Holy Ghost? You just have to be born again. Second, by believing and abiding in Christ, waiting and expecting and being totally surrendered to all that he has for you. Wait, expect, and yield your vessel to him. If you come down and we lay hands on you and you don't receive, Sister Cindy, you keep on asking. You don't give up. You don't back down. Amen. Sister Cindy, we know it. Hallelujah. Glory to God. For anyone who wants to receive this baptism, it is open to everyone that's here. But don't give up if you don't receive. Amen. Glory to God. Just keep seeking him. Keep hungering after his word. I did not receive when I first started seeking the Holy Ghost. When I gave my heart and my life to the Lord, Crystal, I had to tarry. I had to read the word. Some people, for some reason, Brother Sean, you can come down and lay hands on you. Just like Paul, they went out and they laid hands on the disciples and they received the Holy Ghost. They were baptized with the speaking of evidence of other tongues. Just happened just like that, because there was some of them that said, you know, we know Jesus, we know John's baptism, but we don't know the Holy Ghost. And Paul said, well, let me lay my hands on you. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And they receive. Some people receive right away. I can't explain it. Amen. But this morning, I want to believe that God's going to touch y'all this morning. I prayed over this service. Amen. I asked God to come in and just to touch y'all, to let a fresh wind blow today across this altar, across these altars this morning. And I'm going to do it a little bit different. Amen. I'm going to ask Brother Sean if he can stand right, just stand before me right here. Sister Stephanie, if you'll come on down and stand right here with me for just a second. Amen. Glory to God. Brother Justin, since you're our deacon, I'm going to ask you to go ahead and come on down. Sister Diane, is she back there?
She's back there. Yeah.
If you want to, she can come and sit on this pew. If we can just kind of move back, because I want to lay hands on y'all's hands this morning. God's here this morning, and he wants to blow on us this morning. He wants to first blow on the ministers, amen, and our deacon. I'm also going to ask my sister back there, if you can have somebody, the music ready, if you'll come up here as well, because how many of y'all know Sister Mary? Sister Mary Brigney, we did, some of us ladies saw her up there at the meeting, amen. And last night I was talking to her on the phone, and she directed me to do something very specific with my sister. She said she has a healing anointing in her hands. And she said for you, she said she wanna, whoo, I feel the Holy Ghost right now. Glory to God. I feel the Holy Ghost right now. Said for her to hold out her hands and for me to anoint both of her hands. So I'm going to be obedient this morning. And when I anoint her hands, she's going to be a part of this. And I'm going to anoint these ministers' hands. And at work, I'm going to pray and ask God to touch each one of y'all, to touch my sister. And then I want to ask every person that will come, we're going to form a kind of like a prayer tunnel this morning. Amen. And if you'll come down believing, I believe God will touch you this morning. That God will give you a fresh touch. But I'm going to tell you something. You have to be willing.
Yes, that's right. Come on.
You have to do your part. We can only lay our hands on you. We can anoint you. We can ask God to fill you. But you've got to open up. And if God speaks through you this morning, if God gives you that evidence of speaking in tongues, don't be afraid. Don't be ashamed. Just speak it out this morning. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. If you'll go ahead and start the music, I'll go ahead and pray with them. And then we'll get ready for the second part. Y'all can sit down if you want to, so you don't have to stand. I know it's hard for some of you to stand.
Lord, yes, Jesus.
Yes.
A fresh dawn.
Thank you. Thank you.
tonight, I would ask everyone to come back at 6 o'clock and see what the woman of God has for us this evening. Amen. Glory to God. Remember to keep our pastor in your prayers. Amen. And Sister Paula, I am believing that Brother Sean, God has heard our prayers today and he is healed. She is healed. Sister Paula, they are healed and made whole. Hallelujah. Thank you, guys. Thank you, everyone. The word of God before you today. Take what God has spoken to our hearts today. The Holy Ghost is for everybody. It's for such a time as this. I do believe that's my sister's